this is really cool. You can actually go to MUFON.com and do this yourself. This is a list. This is just from the year 2000. I punched in the entity encounters that have been reported directly to the Mutual UFO Network. And these are all abduction events or entity encounters that have occurred within the last 10 years reported directly to MUFON. So some of the people, it's a rare thing I get, but some people come up to me and say, oh, wasn't that big in the 80s or the 90s, and isn't that over with now? This shows you that it's definitely not over. Here's a map of Michigan. Now, this is not in the last 10 years. This is sort of a lifetime map. So not as many, of course, across the country as across the country, but Michigan still definitely has a lot of experiences. And one of the things I want to point out here, too, just really quickly, you might hear a lot of times that, oh, you know, when the aliens come, they always pick up Billy Joel out of the trailer park somewhere. Anytime you do, you punch in the data, either for UFO sightings or for abduction events, what you get is always essentially a population map. Southeastern Michigan, the Grand Rapids area, Traverse City, wherever you have these types of things reported is pretty much where people live. This thing is happening, these experiences are happening everywhere, all the time. It's not just some isolated event out someplace rural. It's very much integrated into wherever you have people living. This is my very first memory in life. I had just turned 2 years old. I was in the crib, very much awake at the time. And when I was laying there, a skull-like face came into the room and up to the foot of the crib and looked down at me. And so as a little kid, what am I gonna do? Of course, is scream for my parents, mommy, daddy, you know? And I didn't get any response from my father. My mother just said, oh, go back to sleep, go back to sleep. And they're right in the hall, and I'm across the hall, and I'm screaming, ah, there's this thing here. And it was very much there. I blinked, you know, I couldn't make this thing go away. It was very much there. And then after a moment, it left the room. Now, many years later, about when I was in my early 20s, I went through a series of hypnotic regressions with the state director at the time of Michigan MUFON. And like most people who have never been hypnotized, there's a bit of skepticism going into it. Is this for real? Are they gonna make me think I'm a chicken? You know, all the crazy things. Am I gonna ever wake up? A lot of questions, is it really gonna pull the truth out? Or is it gonna make me make up stuff in my head that's not true? So, or can I even be hypnotized at all? You know, all the big questions going under hypnosis. So when I went to her, I had a lot of events, as of course, you know, but we decided to start with the very first memory in life. Now, there were a couple things when I went into this hypnosis session that I was curious about. One is why I couldn't remember which brother of mine was in the room with me at the time. I have four older brothers. Our house wasn't that big. And I've always throughout my life remembered sharing a room with a brother, but I couldn't figure out which brother was sharing a room with me at that time, though I know it must have been the case. And the other thing is my foot of my crib, as I recalled it, had bars. So why couldn't I see the body of the entity that had come to the foot of my crib? It was only the head.